partial? No wonderment. Have you seen some people? They look at Buffalo, they look at Miss World, both are same. There's no sense of wonderment. I'm not joking. I've seen in so many workshops I take to all sections of people, and especially to the IT industry. I come from an IT hub in Bangalore. I am known for giving jokes. The best of jokes I crack, some people, especially in the IT industry, they look at me like this. They study my software and hardware, but they won't laugh. One person was sitting right in front of me. I was cracking all jokes. He was just like a masala dosa look. He was looking at me. I asked him, why are you not laughing? He said, why should I laugh? Any question I ask, he says, why? I asked him, what is your name? He said, why Venkatesh? Everything. I'm not joking, some people, there's no wow, and still they get married, and still they go to honeymoon, and they come out from honeymoon exhausted rather than excited, and still they have children, and they ask me, Swamiji, you have written 82 books, have you written a book for children? Why, my son is serious? I said, what can I do? Manufacturer's defect. Your whole honeymoon, like that you have been. I'm not joking. There are some people, there's no sense of wow in people. There's no sense of wow. In one of my workshops that I take, you know, every 2 hours is a break. I take for companies, every 2 hours is a break. Break time, I tell them to mix around, and some people mess around. And one person came back from the break with asthma. He said, Swamiji, one of your students told me, I love you. I said, somebody tells you I love you must be happy, no? To a buffalo like you, somebody still loves you. See, what I'm saying, there's no sense of wow in people. There's no sense of wow. Alright, I mean, no sense of wow, you miss it. You miss the ecstasy of life. So whatever happens to your life, sir, look at the change and see that wow. See the miracle happening. Your eyes are all blinking. Yes or no? See, some of you are doubtfully saying that. No, winking is your project, blinking. Your eyes are blinking, isn't it? Yes or no? Is it not a wow experience? Is it not a wow experience? No, I can see you doubtfully saying that. I tell you, there is an ailment where your blinking stops. It becomes like this. It's a very big nuisance. You know, then dust particles will come. Your eyes are blinking, isn't it? I see that nobody has that problem here. Alright, it's such an experience, your eyes blinking. Because if it stops blinking, right, there's a kind of paralysis. If dust particle goes, you will see the problem. Your eyes are blinking, is such a wow. It's such an ecstasy. All of you went for bathroom today? Yes or no? It's a wow. Say wow. Wow. My God, bathroom. Wow. Wow. Your kidneys working. Wow. Wow. Your liver. Wow. Your heart. Wow. Everything is your. When your wife leaves you. Wow. Wow. Husband leaves you. Wow. Why can't there be a wow experience? Alright, because we have not brought this energy in the forefront. So everything, you know, is becomes complicated, serious. So the next, Vismayaha Yoga Bhumika. Shiva in the Shiva Sutra says, your basis of life should be wonderment. Alright, and with that sense of wow, look at the unpredictabilities of life. Look at the challenges of life. The third paradigm, next paradigm, please, a spiritual paradigm. Is whatever happens in your life, your ground of being should be one of joy. Anandam brahmet vijanat anandat eva kalvimani bhutani jayante. He says everything is ananda, once of joy. Anything is joy. We are all caught up in pleasure. Pleasure has its place. But you are mistaking pleasure to be joy. That's another big error. Right? This is a very big topic. I know you had a lot of pleasure yesterday. I'm not getting that. Pleasure has its place. But pleasure is not equal to joy. Right? Joy is very, very different. So whatever you do, feel the joy. It's a contextual shift. Enjoy what you're doing. So if there's unpredictability, enjoy it. Don't look at it as pain. Because as you start looking, you're going to create that energy. Look at it as joy. Alright, I say whatever you do, enjoy it. Not smoking, drinking, just enjoy. Alright, in Baroda, I was giving a series of talks in Baroda. At the end of my Bhagavad Gita talk, one person came to me and said, Swamiji, too much of problem. I asked, what is the problem? My wife's problem, Swamiji. I said, what is the problem? See, Swamiji, my wife, right, you are not married, you can give a discourse, you get married to my wife, then you will see what is your problem. Your name Ananda will go away, he said. I said, what is it you want? See, Swamiji, I'm a businessman, I come home late, and my wife started nagging. My BP went up. Alright, went up, I got so angry, I threw the cup and saucer, the TV broke. I thought my wife will be unhappy, I found her happy, she said. Swamiji, if this continues, I'm scared where my VCR will break. To save my VCR, give me a mantra. Not to save the relationship, to save the VCR. So then I gave him a lot of techniques, breathing techniques, blah, 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 blah. So many techniques, lack of time, I will not dwell. But still, I said, you have to balance between work and home. I gave him some techniques. He will come home a little late, bring special gift to her. Alright, you talk to her sweetly when you're coming home. But try to balance work and home. All this, I said, still you are late. Simply enjoy your wife's nagging. He said, how can you enjoy the nagging? I said, do you take alcohol? He said, yes. When you take alcohol, it is what gulab jamun taste. Initially it was bitter. But as you go on taking, you get a kick out of alcohol. All of you know better. You get a kick out of alcohol. I said, same way, your wife's nagging or husband nagging, any of these two, wife nagging, husband, initially it will be like alcohol. You go on enjoying, you'll get a kick. Which side depends on your position, I said. Alright, lot of Gujaratis are very devotional people, you know. Very devotional people, and they were very happy at the end. She prostrated and went away. I'm not joking, it's a true story. After 1 week, he comes to me and says, Swamiji, it really works what you said. I said, what happened? See, I came home, Swamiji, my wife started nagging. Alright, my PP went up. I immediately remembered, enjoy the nagging. I folded my hands, let me enjoy. And for the first time, Swamiji, I realized how wonderfully my wife nags. She has not gone through any communication workshops. She is 9th standard fail. But in her, so much of communication tips she gave me. And what are the communication? In her nagging, there was pace, pause, pitch, punctuation, voice modulation, open statement, close statement, funnel technique, multiple closes, disarming technique, and also preemptive strike. My God, all communication skills. Alright? And then I said, my God, I saw, why is she nagging me? Because she loves me. My God, I'm so happy she loves me in spite of my being late, in spite of options available, still she loves me. I stopped all logic. I simply went to her, hugged her. I said, I'm sorry. She started crying. I started crying. Problem was not solved. Problem got dissolved. After 7 years, I went to Baroda and says, Patel saab, su kabar che? He said, maja me che. I said, how is the relationship going on? He says, please, nagging continues. My enjoyment continues. Your problems will continue and your capacity to enjoy should continue. Like a sportsman, every game is going to be difficult, but he enjoys the difficulty. Every game is unpredictable, unpredictably adds thrill to the game. Alright, and therefore we need to enjoy, meet the challenges of life with enjoyment, with a tremendous passion of enjoyment. And when you start doing that, please understand, you will not be a victim of hurt. Every unpredictability hurts us. And then when you get hurt, there is an engram called hurt created in you. And when an engram called hurt created in you, and your boss says idiot, or your boss says monkey, you get hurt. Are, your boss says monkey, why should you get hurt? If your boss calls you monkey, simply look here, make sure there are no monkeys. Doubly check up yourself, sometimes genetical changes can happen. Sometimes genetical changes, according to Darwin, we come from monkeys. And simply tell him, sir, go to an ophthalmologist and get your eyes checked up. But he says monkey, you say donkey, he says buffalo, you say bulldog. All because you have a doubt, I may be a monkey. Why should you get hurt? If somebody calls you a monkey, tell me friends, the word, please listen very deeply to me. Somebody calls you a monkey, what, how can the word monkey hurt? Word monkey is just monkey. Just word monkey. That's all. Somebody calls you an idiot means just idiot. Simply one, thoda hawa hai. It's just a breeze from his mouth. Idiot. Why you have to give me that attitude? Oh, I am PhD, somebody said. How can you be an idiot? PhD means what? Permanent head damage, that's all. Are, if you are PhD, you are not an idiot, why get hurt? And even if you are an idiot, it's a statement of fact.